How you doing, guys? Today, I'm going to go over some stuff I learned during my last year and a half of crossbow hunting. I'm a new hunter, and because of that, I've learned a lot over the last year and a half, and I'm here today to share that with you. Today, the topic of the discussion is going to be on crossbow accessories and things I learned about them to kind of point you guys in the right direction so you don't make some of the same mistakes that I have. So, first and most important for a crossbow, you need a cocker. You could buy hand crank cockers that actually mount to your specific bow, or you could buy a basic one just like this. And basically, it's simply just two hooks with little pulleys in the side and two handles. And all you do is get your hooks like so, pull them apart, set them on the back of your crossbow. Make it so your hooks grab the rope, right? Put your foot on the ground and pull both ends, okay? And you're gonna pull all the way back until your rope on your crossbow comes all the way back here and locks and clicks. At that point, you'll be able to release pressure on your auto cocker and your rope will stay back here, okay? You could probably buy real fancy ones if you want. I bought these at Dick's Sporting Goods, which is a local retailer out here in the Midwest. I think I paid maybe $15, maybe $10 for them. They've worked great. I don't think there's any big improvements in the world of auto cockers like this. So I would go with this. That's what I would recommend. You could buy the fancy ones you hand cranked it or attached to the bow, but I've talked to guys at the shop and they say it kind of is a pain in the butt to have to deal with that. Next up, a lit knock, okay? I'm gonna go over arrows in another video, but a lit knock is an awesome thing to have. And the reason why, and it really helped me this year, is when you're hunting for deer, you tend to do it at dusk and dawn and you run into the darkness there. What happens is after this arrow is deployed, there's a little button right in the back of the nock, which is this metal piece in the back of the arrow. And what happens is that button gets pushed once the arrow is shot. Okay, there's an LED bulb in here and it lights up ultra bright. So after you stick the deer and it runs, you can see where it's going. Also, I found out to be nice if you take a shot and you miss, you'll see your arrow on the ground. This year I actually shot a deer and hit it with such force it went all the way through the deer and stuck in the ground. The deer took off and I thought I missed the shot. However, when I went to collect the arrow and I saw blood and fur on there, I was obviously mistaken, I found out. Next up, broadheads, okay? Basically, you have two different types of heads you can use in a bow. You have a broadhead, which is just fixed, it doesn't move, or you have a mechanical head like this. When you have a mechanical head, basically these little thumbs get pushed down once it pierces the prey you're after, and then these metal blades come up like so, okay, and then expands the head. And the nice thing about that is, you have on this, you have a 2-inch wide cutting diameter when it's fully out, and it definitely makes a difference when you're hunting the animal. Another nice thing too with these is if you have a broadhead and you're going to shoot to sight in or zero your crossbow and you're shooting broadheads, you have a normal tip like this called a target tip. You have to shoot to zero in, but then you have to put broadheads in and they mess up the weight of your whole bow. So what you could do is with this style of broadhead, and I'm gonna make a video on that in the next couple minutes here, you don't have to shoot these actual heads. You could get a tip, I believe I have one here, that is the same weight as that broadhead tip and it'll hit just the same. So you don't have to worry about shooting your broadheads at special targets and things like that. You could just use a normal target and use the special target head. I bought this in my archery shop. Every archery shop in the country should have something like that. Another nice thing that I learned is all my archery equipment, extra tips, target tips, broadheads, all the wrenches that came with my bow. I keep them all in this little plastic organizer I got at Walmart for $4. I also keep my wax in here for the crossbow. And I just keep it closed up, locked, and I keep it in the trunk with me during the season. So in case I have to tighten any bolts or anything that came loose in the bow, which I haven't encountered this year, everything's here ready to go. Another thing that a lot of people that are new to shooting crossbows aren't aware of is wax. Okay, there's two different types. This is a lube, this is an actual wax. All it does is, when you're shooting your bow, this piece of string here that actually propels the bolt out, it rubs on here and creates a lot of friction, right? You don't want that. So what you do is you get this crossbow wax and you just rub it on here and you wipe it on with your fingers so it's nice and evenly on there. And what that does is it reduces the friction. So either way, I hope you guys enjoyed everything I showed you here. Like always, if you like what you see, please like it and subscribe. I'll see you guys. Have a great day, and I look forward to hearing from you in the comments.